The question, what is beyond the borders of the universe, is one of the most interesting questions asked by humanity since its beginning. However, the answer is complex, and we need to define the word universe first. If the universe literally represents everything that can exist throughout space and time, then nothing can exist beyond it. If you imagine that the universe has a certain size, and that there's something beyond that volume, then whatever is outside it is considered a part of the universe. If the universe is infinite, then there is no need to deal with this problem. An infinitely large universe has no edge, so there is nothing to talk about outside it. Of course, there is something beyond our observable universe. Due to the age of the universe and the speed of light, we have not been able to receive light from every galaxy in the universe. The current width of our observable universe is about 90 billion light years, and beyond this limit, there are likely random stars and galaxies. However, there is not much to say about what is beyond it. Cosmologists are unsure whether the universe is infinitely large or extremely large. Astronomers look at the curvature of the cosmos to measure the universe. The large-scale geometry of the universe provides information about its general shape. If the universe is geometrically completely flat, it could be infinite. If it is curved, like the surface of the Earth, then it has a finite volume. Current observations and measurements of the curvature of the universe show that it is almost completely flat. However, this does not mean that the universe is infinite. In a completely flat universe, cosmos does not have to be infinite. It can have a finite volume, like the surface of a cylinder, where parallel lines drawn on the surface remain parallel and still have a finite size. The same could be true for the universe. It could be completely flat, but still be closed upon itself. However, the finite size of the universe does not mean it has an edge or outside. Our three-dimensional universe may be embedded in a larger, multidimensional structure. This is part of some exotic physics models and has no real testable way, but it does not have much effect on the everyday workings of the cosmos. And I know this is a very headache-inducing topic, but even if the universe has a finite volume, it doesn't have to be embedded. When thinking about the universe, one can imagine a vast sphere filled with stars, galaxies, and various astrophysical objects. However, the universe doesn't require an external perspective to exist. A three-dimensional universe can be mathematically defined without the need for something outside of it. The idea of a finite universe existing in an empty void may seem impossible to define, even mathematically. Asking what is outside of the universe is like asking, what sound does the color purple make? It's an absurd question that combines two unrelated concepts. However, the mathematics behind the universe doesn't require anything beyond the universe to define it. The complexity of modern cosmology allows us to develop tools to deal with concepts beyond our imagination. These tools enable us to study the seemingly incomprehensible aspects of the universe.